Good evening, my Real News Media TV family. Welcome back to the channel for another news update for March 20, 2024. And in the news this evening, St. Catherine's school worker charged for sexually assaulting minors. Cops from the St. Catherine North Police have arrested and charged an ancillary worker of an educational institution after he allegedly sexually assaulted two students. It is reported that in early February, the worker lured the two female students to his home with a promise of a monetary reward of $40,000. It is further reported that when the two students turned up at his home, the accused sexually assaulted both. The police were contacted after the action of the accused was revealed. He was picked up by the police and was subsequently charged with two counts of having sex with a person under the age of 16. Unidentified man killed in Crossroads. An unidentified man was shot and killed in Crossroads, St. Andrew, on Wednesday morning, the police report. The news understands that the victim was shot sometime after 6 a.m. in the usually busy section of the area that intersects with Halfway Tree Road. It is reported that loud explosions were heard, followed by the sound of a car speeding off. When the noises subsided, the man was found suffering from gunshot wounds. He was rushed to a nearby hospital where he was pronounced dead. The police have since launched an investigation into the matter. There has been an 89% increase in murders in the St. Andrew Central Police Division year on year. As at March 16, homicides were numbered at 17. This is 8 more than the 9 recorded for the period in 2023. Alpha Primary School mourns the death of principal. The Alpha Primary School in St. Andrew was thrown into mourning today following the death of its principal, Yvette Samuels. The news understands that Samuels, who headed the institution for the last 7 years, was a breast cancer survivor. However, the illness had returned. Guidance counselors have since been dispatched to the school to provide counseling for teachers. However, students who are currently sitting their primary exit profile exams have not yet been notified. Those students love the principal dearly, and I believe it will affect their exams, a school official who requested anonymity told the news. Goldings comments an attack on House Speaker, says Clark. Finance Minister Dr. Nigel Clark says that the opposition leader's comments on Tuesday were an attack on the office of the Speaker of the House. During his contribution to the budget debate in the House of Representatives on Tuesday, opposition leader Mark Golding raised the issues about the government's transparency and accountability to good governance, noting that having the head of parliament, who is the spouse of the head of government, does not sit well with the tradition that a speaker must act independently of the government of the day. But Dr. Clark believes another avenue should have been found to raise the concerns relating to House Speaker Juliet Holness. He also noted that Mr. Golding and other opposition members have been inconsistent on matters of national importance, which calls into question whether they can be trusted.
Now that the opposition leader has a disagreement with the speaker on matters of law and statute, instead of taking his case to the Jamaican people and arguing his case, what he chooses to do is to indirectly attack her intellect and character by suggesting that her actions and decisions are motivated by something other than her independent thought and reason, and that is low and underhand.
Chairman of the People's National Party and a Member of Parliament, Dr. Angela Brownberg, has said that the opposition is not calling for Juliet Holness to resign as a Speaker of the House of Representatives. Dr. Brownberg said it is tradition that a government selects the Speaker, and this is accepted. But she noted that the opposition has a liberty to assess the decision because of the conundrum in which it has been placed. Dr. Brown, speaking with the news, stated further that the government's stance on opposition leader Mark Golding's comments on Tuesday raises questions about its position on good governance and ethical principles. She said the comments were not an attack on the competencies of Mrs. Holness.
There are three arms of government that underpin the democracy in which we are. To have two arms of those, of that being led by a husband and wife here doesn't look good. As Jamaicans would say, it not look good, it not smell good. And for anyone in government, any right-thinking Jamaican to look at that and say that they don't understand why anyone would believe that's a problem, that would be the problem for me.
Golding had a strong grounds to question Speaker's performance, says a commentator. Political commentator Lloyd B. Smith says opposition leader Mark Golding had strong grounds on which to raise the concern about the performance of Speaker of the House Juliet Holness during his budget debate presentation on Tuesday. But Mr. Smith also believes the timing of the comments, based on circumstantial evidence, could be seen as distasteful. While speaking about the transparency and accountability to good governance, Mr. Golding noted that having a head of parliament who is the spouse of the head of government does not sit well with the tradition that a speaker must act independently of the government of the day. This triggered an unprecedented walkout of government members, led by Prime Minister Andrew Holness, leaving the parliament without a quorum. In an interview with the news, Mr. Smith said the move by the government side was regrettable and it did not help the country's image.
I think there should have been some other way that the Prime Minister, after all, he has his own presentation coming up and he should have then dealt with the matter in a more gentlemanly way. But I just thought that his rushing to leave the Parliament in the dust was a bit churlish and not becoming of a Prime Minister. He ought to have shown a greater level of self-control. Mr. Golding didn't say anything that was false or untrue. That's the point that had to be made, that all the points that he made regarding the speaker were in fact correct in most instances, if not in all instances. The fact that he drew the correlation between her being his wife and therefore the head of parliament versus the head of government are, shall we say, entangled? Yes. That could have been embarrassing in any situation, whether in or outside of Parliament. And I don't know if there was a more subtle way that Mr. Golding perhaps could have handled that. We delved into a number of very salient points relating to the question of how best to ensure that what he terms the trickle-down economics practiced by the DLP could be reversed and thus move the country away from a low-tech, low-wage, low-productivity environment. And I thought that was a very nice point of departure and augurs well for the country if some of those points are taken on by the government and should his party become government to pursue them.
15-year-old girl gone missing in St. Andrew. An another alert has been activated for 15-year-old Rihanna Williams of Baldwin Crescent, St. Andrew, who has been missing since Monday, March 18. She is of dark complexion and medium build and about 145 centimeters or 4 feet 9 inches tall. Reports from the Doheny Park Police are that Rihanna was last seen at home, dressed in her school uniform, a white blouse, gray tunic and a pair of black shoes. All efforts to contact her since then have been unsuccessful. Anyone knowing the whereabouts of Rihanna Williams is asked to contact the Doheny Park Police at 876-933-4280, the 119 police emergency number, or the nearest police station. Relatives of young man killed by cops demand justice. The family of 27-year-old Romario Sterling, who was last Thursday fatally shot by police officers, are disputing claims that he met his demise in an alleged shootout. The police are reporting that about 8 p.m. on March 14, a team went on an operation in the Pineapple Lane community of Bogwalk, St. Catherine, and Sterling was shot during a confrontation with them. The police reported that they seized a 9mm pistol with a magazine loaded with 8 9mm rounds. However, Sterling's relatives are distraught and disappointed as they say the reporter couldn't be further from the truth. This was a case of mistaken identity, and we, the family of innocent Romario, will not cease until this situation gets national attention a relative told the news. A video clip seen by the news team seems to give some credence to the relative's claim that there was no confrontation between Sterling and the police. In the video clip, the now deceased is seen dressed in white with his hands behind his head as one of the policemen on location appeared to be speaking to him. Throughout the clip, other police officers appeared to be milling around. Sterling, from the video clip, appears to comply as he seemingly kneels down. The footage cuts off. However, based on the timestamp on the clip with the video again captured the movement, gunfire is heard shortly afterwards. The relatives who spoke with the news said that after the shooting, the camera system was reportedly dismantled by the law enforcers. Sterling don't keep company, and he has one friend. He mostly plays marbles with the kids, and on Friday, he would go to a bar with his only friend. He's not involved in anything. He wasn't wanted, the relative said. The relative said that Sterling moved to the area from Old Harbor about 6 years ago when there was a flare-up of violence in that community. According to the relative, aside from the Independent Commission of Investigations, no one else has spoken to the family following the incident. The police said Indicom and the Inspectorate and the Professional Oversight Bureau are investigating the police fatal shooting.